First you want to be an actor, then you want to be Barry Manilow, and you know what they say about him.
Thank God for Mackie. She made a pledge. She's going to stop all this union stuff.
I know, good for her. Just wish she'd hurry up.
Well, what's it all for? She can end up in Birmingham rep saying anyone for tennis.
All right, you've made your point.
Well, so cutting the speed now, right? Is that, shall I just shut up?
Yes!
What do they say about Barry Manilow?
Your father says he's queer, which is ridiculous. The ladies love him.
The ladies love Liberace, too.
Oh, it doesn't count. Might take a while, yeah?
We're not a couple, though. I've told you, we're really not.
Well, I'm hardly an expert, but from the little I can gather, good acting is when it's true, isn't it?
Nice try, Bubby. Nice try. Bitch is slaying.
Ah, you look lovely.
Gregory's outside, he's waiting.
See you later.
Aw. Gregory's actually a little bit of a sweetie. Oh, bitch. Dear, that is a hate fuck. That is getting out some aggression.
I have you ever had sex?
Yeah.
When?
It's all on expenses. Hard work, though. Don't go thinking it's a little jolly.
Yeah.
You're there to do exactly what Mr. Hart says.
And don't fuck any Americans. Not because of the AIDS, just because Americans. Fuck! Bitches extra.
Do you know what it really is, AIDS? It's a racket. It's a money-making scheme for drugs companies.
Do you seriously think there's an illness that only kills gay men? It can calculate that you're gay and kill you, but no one else. Because imagine it. Gay cancer. How is
this scene is such
gay?
A surreal element, but it's
like?
So
it
well
pink?
Done.
Where is it? Is it in the wrist? I mean, for God's sake. You get all these stories and all these rumours and all these nightmares. Because that's what they want you to think, that lot. They say it's spread by poppers.
Yes! Okay, I have talked about this in my poppers videos. The whole reason, even today, that we still have so many regulations and restrictions on poppers being sold online in stores, be able to be sold as leather cleaner or as room odorizer, but not as actual, you know, a recreational inhalant for relaxing during sex, which is what it is. And if we sold it like that and were open about it, it would make it a lot less likely to be abused, misused, mistreated, and for people to sell utter crap labeled as poppers. The whole thing stems from this. The fact that poppers were attributed to the increase in risky sex that led to AIDS, and thus there were all these restrictions and laws and stuff put on them, but not all the way. Poppers literally has nothing to do with AIDS or HIV or any STD, really. And sure, people may use it when they're doing some things that are a little bit more sexually out there, but no. But yes, this...
They say it arrived from outer space on a comet, and they say that God created it to strike us dead.
Yeah, fuck you, bitch.
They say there's one patient zero spreading it wherever he goes.
I mean, if you, oh God.
Homosexuals, patients, and hemophiliacs, like, there's a disease which has targeted the letter H. I don't believe a word of it. Now hit me with those lasers, please.
Really, like, okay, especially with COVID going around, a lot of people have been comparing this pandemic to the AIDS pandemic. But the thing is, like, with COVID, we had answers right away. Okay, sure, in America, we had a government and a certain politician who was, like, putting all these seeds of doubt into it and questioning things and making it sound like it was made up and etc. But outside of that, we had actual facts, we had actual reporting, we had actual data coming out. So, with COVID, yeah, we were pretty prepared, and the people who were ignoring it were idiots. With GRID and AIDS, when this was happening, That literally wasn't there. It was out there. It was something that was being reported as happening, but no one was researching it, no one was looking into it. And of course, one of the main reasons for that is because of people like Margaret fucking Thatcher and Ronald Reagan, who blocked all this research and were ignoring it and sweeping it under the rug because it was only affecting gay people. It wasn't really until HIV started being prevalent among, you know, straight people and married families and even, hell, drug users, that it became something to be worth looking at. When it was gay people, who cares? So, you can't really blame him in this case. You can't blame these people, I think, because everything around it was so bullshitty and, like, fractured and broken.
Hi, Gloria. Nice uniform.
Of course I will. We'll come around tonight. I'll bring the boys.
No, don't tell anyone, okay? Don't tell that lot. I mean it. I swear to God, don't tell anyone.
Why not?
I don't want anyone to know. That's why I phoned you. Please.
Like, even if it's just getting Gloria. Normally sick,
Mom.
Is it gonna be, like... Just because there's these rumors going around, you don't want people to know you're sick, and...
Just keep your distance. They said it was tuberculosis.
Oh my God, that's infectious. You let me walk inside?
No, but it stopped. I'm getting better. I had this cough and it stopped. Look,
all of the misdiagnoses.
No, I'm not better than I was.
So what did the doctor say?
Which, again, is one of the reasons why no one took it seriously and thought it was like a scam.
Have you ever had sex with animals?
What?
Have you ever had sex with animals?
I don't understand.
It said in the questionnaire, have you ever had sex with animals?
But why?
They don't think that it's tuberculosis.
For me, baby. Oh, do it, do it, do it. Give me more.
She has absolutely nothing to worry about, luckily, but shit, that amount of fear and uncertainty that no one knew.
Big surprise, we were heading back from Pamela Tanner's.
Oh, she's having a party next Saturday, so we can all come.
And guess who we bumped into, long time no see?
Ta-da!
Oh my God.
I'm feeling a lot better now, I really am.
Glad to hear it. See you soon. I'll come round one day, yeah?
Yeah, that'd be nice.
One day.
Bye.
Thing is, his dad's a moneybags. He's in the tax office. Apparently they've got a really nice house in the posh bit of Glasgow.
I know.
It literally doesn't affect you.
I know, but friends of mine, I just want to help. Have you got anything, any booklet?
Why would I? I don't understand what you mean. Why on earth would I have anything to do with that? Are we done?
Yes.
Good.
The mindset of...
We're only going for 3 days, but Mr. Hart says I need a different suit for every day.
In America, it's more advanced, so here's 20 quid. Go to those bookshops and anything you can find. Buy it for me. Okay?
Bless this girl!
Oh, darling, it's breaking
my heart. She is amazing.
That's a postcard.
Have you? We stayed in a better class of hotel back then. Room 218. That's you. Oh, 209. Right opposite.
The coincidence.
I'll leave you to your own devices tonight. I'll be dining with the Bridges.
He needs comfort. He needs help.
Why? What's wrong with him?
Us. It's because of us. We broke his heart, Roscoe. I got pregnant. You got Ben. And he walks around all day in despair.
Oh, boo-hoo!
The wine was a gift. And rather expensive. But I don't want to carry it home in my suitcase, so it would be rude not to share.
Oh, dear. God damn it, you creepy old perv.
Do you have a nice night?
It's not that he's old. It's just that, oh my God.
Yeah.
He's so taking advantage of his position as a superior to do this kind of shit.
Oh, it takes a while for the pipes in these old buildings. I had to stand there waiting, naked, for 10 minutes.
Charming.
But then I got a good hot steam. It's important to be clean, don't you think?
Yeah, we've had this discussion before.
Colin? Shower or bath?
I like a shower.
So you smell clean. Our boys together. Come and sit with me.
Bruh. No means no. Oh, maybe that'll get the shut up.
Better get some sleep.
Baldoons.
Thank you, AIDS!
Yes, sir.
Good night, then.
Forget I said that.
Good night.
Thank you. But nothing.
Fuck you.
Connie Jingle.
Double fuck you.
Ricky. Hey?
Stab him in the eye with it.
I made some food.
Fuck off.
Eat shit and die.
Funny thing is, steam really does rise up from the street. Not like in the films, steam from the subway.
He is so cute.
I'm sorry. I did look for that stuff, but I couldn't find anything anyway. I did try.
Oh, well, that's okay. Never mind.
No, I'm lying. Here you are.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
You fibber. Do you have an address for Gloria? I mean, Gregory. A home address in Glasgow.
For Gloria?
Have you? Why?
I've got everything.
I don't know his father's name, but the surname is Finch.
It was the ultimate insult to injury that these gay people would get AIDS. Their families would take them in to help.
Apparently,
but then just like shut them out and lock them away from anyone who cared about them.
It was brilliant.
And New York?
Amazing.
So because the guy saw the AIDS stuff in his room, he has decided, oh, for fuck. But did he do it because of the AIDS stuff or because he was rejected? No. Fuck.
I don't understand.
Which, like I brought up last time, is why we really need to get rid of at will
like
hiring
you're
and firing.
You're not employed anymore.
Can I stay?
I'm afraid not.
Goddamn Dolores Umbridge, little uptight, snarky cuntwazzle. Aww. Complete and utter bullshit of it.
Sometimes when I think of her name, when it's only a game, and I need you.
Aw, he found another job.
When I see you, all
that's
I
wonderful.
Needed was a love you gave. All I needed for another day.
Oh shit. This is when it started actually getting.
And I wonder what's mine. Can't take no more.
And then there was that shit happening.
Behind a closed door. All I needed was the love you gave. All I needed for another.
Return to sender? Or. Oh no, it got there. Why? Why the f- Oh my god, this show is gonna do a number on me. Alright, so alright, so this is the end of my part one reaction to It's a Sin, Russell T Davies, Ollie Alexander, such a great and awesome cast, like, oh my fucking god, they're amazing. But yeah, this is my reaction to the first two episodes. I'll probably do the next two real soon, and I don't know if I'm going to do part one, part two, part three, or if I might just like cram all last three episodes. Like, I feel like this is going to be pretty huge, so I'll probably do the last episode standalone. We'll see. But yeah, if you enjoyed the video, like, comment, subscribe. I will see you guys in the next one. And of course, remember, life always gets better as long as you work a different by brick. See ya!